Yeah, that's some nice fur.
This is a P-Port 1.7 gig. We're going to try upgrading it to a 2 gig. We'll even accept the upgrade. And the RAM is two sticks of 256 DDR2. It makes it 512. Unfortunately, it only has two slots, so I don't think I can really upgrade that anymore. This RAM's, unless it's a special order, the RAM, it's old. But I think first what we're going to do is we're going to clean it out. It's got a little bit of hair in it. It could become a problem eventually. And we'll drop the processor in and see if it speeds it up any. Well, someone down the road put a really, really nice heatsink in this tower. Solid copper. But, got a little bit of hair on it. So we're gonna have to vacuum it out. We'll try changing the chip out before we, clean up first. That's cleaned out again. I just upgraded to 2 gig. As you can see, the Windows experience is 1. So we're doing the new hardware detector thing, and we're going to do another benchmark to see what it comes up as. Well, it's still 1. That would be the lowest rating is the 3D business and gaming graphics performance. So we'll switch the video card out and see if we can get that up a bit. Well, after further testing, this thing is really not worth it. I mean, that really slows it down on Windows 7 is the fact that it's got the old IDE 133 hard drive. There's no SATA or anything like that on it. So what I'm going to do is I'll buy her a refurbished one, maybe a dual with SATA and everything else. And we're going to turn this one into a either 98 or 95 rig. And I have about, 15 years worth of games. I have the original Duke Nukem, bunch of other games that, DOS-based games that I would like to run. And this is a nice solid workstation that I would like to set up as one. So keep this one, buy her another one. So let's load it up. See, make a video of some of the old games, like Quake 2, Quake 1, Quake 3 would probably run on this too. We'll see. You know, at least we got the operating system on it. Talk about a pain. I'm trying to find drivers. I can't even plug my USB stick into it because it doesn't detect it. But it's coming along. I'm just doing video drivers, and then I'll start loading up some of the games.